couple of tags that are ripping off on the sides as compression straps to sort of pull it in and that, and I thought we could put cords all over.
Nice and small anyway.
Yeah, since we've been here a while, the wildlife. Yeah,
gotten used to.
And, yeah, John's been feeding the possums of the night time. Baby, a mother with a baby on the back.
Yeah.
Mm, I got a full pat on it last night. So I scratched the head. And when I come out, the rangers were there, so we're having a yak to these two rangers. And telling them a bit about what we're doing and the other weekend and whatnot. And, oh, that's bloody cool, you know. So, good contact to have. Nice guys, eh? So.
Stop bullying the bird. The magpie's bullying the little miner.
Get just as much as they get.
Yeah.
Caroline came up twice. They've gone home because they got a bit of property. And Ross and I said, oh, I'm going to check this conifer looking tree up near the Dunnies up there, you know, because it looked a bit like pine. It had little tiny leaves that are a little bit prickly on the ends, sort of similar to the similar but not to the little spiky ones on a bunya pine, you know, the little leaves that
are
more spiky on that thing.
Yeah.
Had the little tiny leaves that are a little bit spiky on the end.
Oh, look at the colour on him.
And I never ever noticed.
It's beautiful. Like that.
Yeah, that's the bear blue.
Yeah,
yeah, but it's like the blue. You know, it's black and sometimes.
Yeah, the females are around, they're the green ones.
Yeah, there's a female over there. It was just in this tree over here just before.
But it's just iridescent sort of blue shine that comes off it when the sun hits it just right. Yeah.
Beside the track there's a dead tree and it had a hollow and then the branch went that way. He says, see that bit of crap there? And it was a bit of she-oak, dead she-oak leaf sort of. You could see that it was sort of like being nested there. He says, that's where they put them in there. And we've only just been talking about it because, you know, the possums are all around here, but you look up the trees, you can't see where they're hanging out.
Yeah. But
bridge was poured here, and then you've got the slag of the cement here where the boxing.
Yeah.
And he's just scratching his heel with his boot on over the edge of that there. Anyway, next thing, I'm looking over the other side, I have my back to them. The next thing I hear, snake. And she just takes off with a torch. She saw it and takes off. Anyway, so it didn't move. And wondering what it is. And she come. It was looked like a little tiger, but yeah, it was arced up and right where he was scratching his foot.
Yeah, I just got them all saved on the computer, most of them. Mm. I just gone through and like, yep, alright, bookmark that one, yep, bookmark that one, bookmark that one. There's a list of like, I think about 8 or 9. All one
what
one.
Do you want? Huh?
Gotta get some money. I was gonna do it this year after I got all the tax back and the pay out from buddy from work cover, but because we didn't have any work, I was sort of like, I bet not, because I can see keep doing it and then I'll have no money. And we still won't have any work.
So watch the kookaburra when you're having your dinner. So the kids might get a bit upset when he flogs their toast out of their hand.
So they got a sweet tooth for toasted marshmallows, eh? Being chased by all the other birds because he's got a bit of toast. Look at him run.
The fella in Gymna, they had a market, and the fella in Gymna was saying,
yeah, the fire tally museum or whatever it was. Yeah,
he said that there's a spot just up on the hill. Near the phone box, I think.
By the actual cell tower. Because this is where we went.
You know, when you get to the top of this, where you head out back onto